deadly medicine. So they have not just any medical study, but then also he has a knowledge of the medicine, he has a knowledge of the supplements, and he is selling that. But if we go and see there his education, he is lying in it. So here also I am telling you and explain you that dominance is not that important. Now see, a Facebook who has opened, his background is engineer. But Facebook is a business, he is a commerce. He did his e-commerce, he started his e-commerce, he is selling goods and services from his part, and his background is engineer. So domain is not important to become a entrepreneur. Alibaba.com, you have listened about this. It is a China company, Alibaba, who has started. He was a teacher. And teacher has started Alibaba business. This is a very big business. Now when we say about the OYO owner, OYO owner age was 21 years and he was college dropout. Means he was not a graduate student also. He has did only 12th standard and then he has started his business and later he has dropped out from the college. Means that education is not important also here. Same thing who has opened the book My Shop through online when you are purchasing and reading the book, then he has, that person has did MBA.
Here is Being Human, it has been opened by the actor and Paytm, that is banned. If we say that a person who is doing the commerce, he will go in the bank. But this ATM person is an engineer and he has started his business. Let's come on the case study. Now see here, that India Films, you have listened this name, India Films. Now see, that who is the founder? He is the Charles Leonel. He is the founder what? He is not a CA, he is not a CS, he is not an advocate. But what India Films do? Through India Films, a businessman pays air taxes. So he is a master degree in airline management. Means that he did his master degree. But in which area? His domain area is airline. But what he is doing? He is doing work in India Films. That means that he started an app for an income tax and that is related with accountant. If he has studied the commerce, if he has studied the account, if he has did the CA or CS, or he is an advocate, he knows the rules and regulations and policies and then he has started the business. But no, he started his business, he was the airline management. Now again, easy start and grow your reach in the Indian Films. This ties with them that easily close a company through India Films. Easily find trademark lawyer through India Films. So through India Films, you can get a lawyer, you can get information and if you want to do a close up, easily through India Films. If you want to open a business, you can open a business. If you want to close your business, you can easily close your business through this channel. If they can do, why not you? You can also do it. Because they are from different domains. They are from different backgrounds. They have did their qualification from different areas. And they have started their business. When they can start their business, then why you cannot start your business? You can also start your business. Now the point is, loss in life. See here. That. This is the age group which I have mentioned. You are a kid, slowly you have grown and you have got a graduation. And 20 to 30 years, this is the time what loss about where you should have for nurturing an idea. But you have spent your time and you have lost this time. So what is going on? What you can do? Getting confused, where to go next, idea, from where it should be come, now where I go, what I do, because I have lost my these 10 years from 20 to 30 to not, I have selected any career and I have lost that. So you are confused with what to do, where to go. Now see, here are the five
essential elements of success when you think that I want to start my business and I want to develop my business and I want to become a successful entrepreneur? Is my voice is clear? All of you are audible?
Yes, madam, it is very much.
Okay. Now see, here we will go in the essential elements of the success. See, here is the idea. When you create idea, then you need a team, then you need a business model, then you need a funding, and then you need a time. Right? So like this, you can make your idea and you can start your venture. So first of all, you need to create an idea. And from where you can create idea, I have given you this message that already this business is go outside in the market. See left, right. Everywhere is a business. You can pick any business and you have to add something innovation and then add the technology and your startup will be started. So you need team, you can hire, you can make a business model that on which model you have to work, how to work, and you need amount. So already the government is helping you with the seed money. You need time to develop. Every business needs a time to develop it. So this, by this way, if you focus on this, you can be a successful entrepreneur. So before you start your own business, what you have to do? You have to need to focus on these thinking. Before starting thinking your startup, you have to focus that who will be your audience, who is going to watch your product. This is a very important. So you have to target the audience. Then you have to target the size of the user. Size of the user means that how many people are going to purchase your product. What would be your business size? How big is your business? What is B2B and B2C? B2C. How you are doing business to business and how you are doing business to consumers and competitor analysis. These all things you have to do before you are starting your business. If you have did this analysis, then you will be successful. There is no chance to be failure. Choose the right niche, what you want. Branding, idea creation, story selling, social media, UX research, UX design, e-commerce development, and photography, video animation, content writing, and hosting solution. Here you have to need, you have to choose the right niche, what is very important for you, what is necessary for you. And choose that branding is important or idea creation is important, storytelling is important or social media is important. You have to search this in yourself and then you can work it. Now see, here is a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 words. One word, there is a different direction and this is on, another are off. Means that all it takes in an innovative that makes you an odd out of all the even in the market. Means that if you are going to start your business, you have to do something different. Whatever these four people are doing, you have to do different. These all are in the downward and you want to go upward. These all are right and you go left. These all are left, you go right. Means you have to do everything in a different manner. Already what is going in the market, you have to change it. That is called innovation. And through this innovation, you can start your business. Now you can see how your friends should work. As an entrepreneur, your brain is a pool of ideas. Lot of ideas are in your brain. Eyes to looking investor and opportunities. Whatever I say, na, aapke khoj rahi hai. Kisko khoj rahi hai? They are searching the investors, those who can invest their money in their business. Now, mouth. Mouth is for the communication, the vision. means you should score like this that the other people can be in touch with you. The mouth is very important. Communication is very important. Ears, listen, customer feedback, what the customers want, what the customer is saying, what the requirement of the customer. So you need the feedback from the customer, so your ears should be ready to listen that feedback. Now stomach. Stomach is for the trust your gut. What you have said, what are the gut in you? And from a stomach, you trust on it. Heart full of passion. Every time you are ready to work your business, you are ready to do a hard work. That is a full passion. If there is a up and down, then also your heart is accepting and they have a passion. They stay on there and they work on that. Feet, that is a dream high up, stick to ground. If you are, your feet are walking to go on the high, means you are not there to stop. You are continuously walking, and your speed is in the search of the growth. Legs, each of them going to the tough side. With the help of the legs, you can go on the tough side. Now here are the 10 startup mistakes when they fail. Failing to ask for help 1.4%. When you are asking someone to help, it means that you are failing. Ignoring social media means you can get lot of information from the social media. And if you are not focusing on there, if you are not getting the information from there, means that you are failing. Building something that nobody wants. Something you are building that nobody wants. Unnecessarily you are building that thing. Means that is the failure point. Hiring poorly means that you are hiring. You don't require them, but you are hiring. It means that your business will be fall down. Lack of the focus. Lack of the focus. 30% means that if you are not focusing on the proper way, means that your business will be fall down. Spending too much money means that you are spending your money too much. You don't care that where you are spending, if there is a necessary or not. If the money has been flow, then you will go in the loss. Not making not making sure you have enough money. 3.3%. Like this, you are chasing investor, not a customer, not having right co-founders, and failing to execute sales and marketing. These are things if you are ignoring, if you are not doing properly, then these mistakes will be fall the business. This mistake will be close the startup. So this is very necessary to understand that you have to not to ignore these all things and focus on them. How can I help you? Now see, this picture shows that the tree is there. It is going under the earth. Means that now you need the help. Setting up of incubator center encourage young members to feel big to achieve bigger. Why we are setting incubator in our organization? Why the government has spoken to set up IIT in each and every institution? Why the entrepreneur development cell has been set up in all the organizations? Why the incubator is there only to encourage the younger people, only those who are interested to become an entrepreneur, to think big and achieve bigger. Next, to provide them support and handholding to their goals. Means, I have given you the example of the incubator. That incubator is to help the newborn baby. Those premature baby has been come in the world. So, they want the feeling of the mother, and that incubator gives that filling and they help them to grow. And we can save their life. Doctor saves their life by the incubator. Same thing, this incubator is also giving your startup. If your startup is falling down, they will nurture you. They will help you and they will grow you. Whole chain program and even from startup. And this is where how you have dead. The chain will be whole by the incubator and they will help you. Change is important. In each and various sectors, change is very important. You have to do the change and then you can continue your business. Now see, don't be afraid in connection to people. Some old technology, due to some old technology, Nokia has started these features in his mobile. But what happened? Nokia failed. But iPhone entered in the market by the complete innovation. And this is the change. Only Nokia has given this, but some other company has changed the feature and added the innovative thing and success in the market. So we need a change when there is something lacking in the business, you need to do little bit changes. Now technology advancement and advancements are bringing change. By the use of the technology, you can do lot of changes. E-commerce, wiping out middlemen, make the things more convenient for professionals, capital and technology replacing labor, consolidation of market players and making a marketplace. So e-commerce is what doing? Through the e-commerce, middlemen are out from that business because that is that the business is going through company to customer. You order through the online and the company packs your product through the shipping and the delivery boy comes and deliver that product at your home. So what happens? The middleman, though, if you go in the indirect marketing and direct marketing, we can see indirect marketing, there is a company, the product was manufactured in the company, from there it comes outward to the wholesaler and retailer and to the customer. So these middlemen have been bypassed by the e-commerce. And it has become a very convenient for a professional. People are doing easy online purchasing through the online market. And capital and technology has been displacing the labor. Now, no investment, no capital. You have to invest to establishing your shop, your mall, or to purchase your shop or hire a shop. Only the replacement of the technology, these all have been changed. Same thing, consolidation of the market players and making a marketplace broad. So these changes have given. Technology has advanced and technology has changed this. Nothing is permanent in technology except change. Now, day by day, the technology is changing features. If we say that earlier we have seen that lot of things have been in the market and we were saying that this is a new technology, but it has changed. Now earlier, when the people want to come on the social media, before 20 years, we know about the Orkut. You have not listened, but in my age group, when we were in the graduation, that time we have listened about the, graduate. Orkut, and we know that through Orkut, people were connecting each other. But what happened? The change has been come, and Facebook has grabbed the market, and now nobody knows about the Orkut, and people know only about the Facebook. When the Facebook came in the market, after that, now Instagram is also there. Same SMS was there earlier, there was a telephone, we were talking, then slowly, slowly the phone has been coming and we were going to give a message, then there was a SMS system, later the WhatsApp has been came and through WhatsApp we were transferring our messages. Now PASU, there were a bank and it has been changed in the ICICI bank. Now you can see that in when we say that Orkut to Facebook, SMS to WhatsApp, PSU to IIC bank, but here is also change from Facebook to Instagram, in the Facebook, WhatsApp, you can see daily the features are changing, daily the technologies are changing.
Earlier there were only a similar, you can post your picture and you can see. Later the messaging system were there. Later the video call were there. Later all the conferences are going there. Later the live telecast can be gone by the Facebook. Same in the WhatsApp. Earlier you can give your message. Later you started to do a call. Later the feature has been developed and you can do a video call. And now you can do a conference video call also, and 4 to 5 people can be connected in the one mobile and talk face to face each other. Same thing, bank is also transferring their money to the online, and the technology is changing lots of things. So we can see that nothing is permanent, everything is changing, and technology is changing the future. Now see what is the generation gap. Here is a business magnet of yesteryear. These folks who demonstrate seriousness and good taste, a perfect folder, pocket square thief of an attention to detail. Earlier, when a person is wearing a suit, dress, tie, coat, then he was called a businessman, gentleman, right? But what is the gap? Now, if you see him, he is wearing jeans and t-shirt, and he is a mark. Zuckerberg, and what is he? He is not wearing coat. This is a change. This is a generation gap. You can see the jeans has been here, and chappal, slippers, flip-flops, sandals he is wearing. Here he is wearing a shoe which is shiny, and both hands free from a firm handshake. Here both hands are busy with a mobile. So this is the generation gap. It's all about mindset. What is your mindset? What you think? Now see, in the previous, inexperience, over authenticity, overconfidence, work, non-traditional style is different. Nowadays, quick learner, walk smartly, quick decision, risk-taking capability, think out of the box. So now the generation gap is there, and the people, the generation always think quickly. They walk smartly, they take a quick decision, they are a risk taker, they have a capability to take the risk, they think out of the box. So this is the change coming out. So due to technology, these changes are coming out. Now, survival of the fitness. What to eat in Italy? Pizza or chapati? Now see what is going on. This is a survival of the fitness. We require chapati to eat, but Italy people cannot survive without chapati, they eat pizza. This is the changes which is in the market, which is related with the startup food. We can say Foodpanda and Zomato, this is a startup. Supply, we can say that Grofer and Big Basket, not a big bazaar. Travel, Yatra.com, Make My Trip, online services. OLX and Kabadi Bazaar. These all are online. Means that you have added innovative idea and technology and you have started your business. These people have started their business only adding the innovation and the technology, and they did the idea. Now these are the companies which is the leading startup in India. Instantly, Grofer, Ola, Zomato, Redbus.in, Porter, Lookup, PeeperTop, FirstKai, Swiggy, Simple Learn, Jugnu. These all are the successful startups which are running in the India, and this startup is success startup. Now the point is that what are the success mantra to become a successful businessman, successful entrepreneur. As earlier we have started that I am going to give you a success mantra. So the success mantra first is got that you need 3 things to create a successful startup. When you are going to start your business, you need 3 things. Number 1, to start with good people. Those people are interested to start business. Those people are ready to work with you. So always select, choose a good people who can do a startup. To make something customers actually want.
means that you want to sell product, but what the customer needs. So first of all, you have to understand the requirement of the customer. What is the need of the customer? And if you are creating that, it means that you can run your business and to spend as little money as possible, not to spend lot of money. In the previous slide, I have told you that those people are spending lot of money. It means that they are wasting their money. So spend lot money, work with good people, and try to give the customer's needs. Then you will run your business very well and your startup will be successful. Second mantra, whether professionals can grasp such changes. Have pride in how far you are, have come, have faith in how far you can go. This should be in your mind. If you put this in your mind, then your business will be so, first of all, you have a pride in how far you, kahan tak aap chale ho. You need to be feel pride. How come, how you have entered in this business, this is important for you. And feel that I have entered in this business. Faith on yourself that how far you can go. So this confidence level will be success you in your business. So this is the second mantra of the success. You have to believe in yourself, you have to faith in yourself, and you have to know that how you have entered in this business and how far you will go in this business. Successful mantra 3. Don't be afraid, because people start their business, but after few times they are afraid that my business will be run or not, maybe it will be fall, maybe I will get a loss. So don't be afraid, only change. It is a leading to a new beginning. If sometimes it falls down, don't worry. You need some change and then you will grow. You need some change and you will grow. So always be not too afraid with the changes. Mantra 4. It is not the strongest or the most intelligent who will survive, but those who can best manage change. Now see, every single survives, but if you manage it, you are successful. This manage is very important. So what we are doing, we have to manage when we have started our business. Even a strong people or an intelligent people who have started their business, they have also survived. And we cannot say that a person who has started their business, they are immediately a successful entrepreneur. No. They have survived and they have faced the problem. And they become the strong, they have managed the changes, and then they become a successful entrepreneur. So these are the 4 mantras. You want to become a successful entrepreneur? And now 5th is what saying you. Dear past, whatever has been passed with you, faith past. Thank you for all the lessons, because lot of things you have learned with your bad experience. So say, thank you, this bad experience has given me a lesson. I have learned something from you. Because when you fall, you learn next time how to stand. So this is a good experience when you fail. If you say that Edison has failed 1,000 times, but later he said that I have learned a lesson from Edison. Dear future, I am ready to face you, because I have learned lot of lessons from my past. So this is a message to my dear students, that be ready to be your future, to be a entrepreneur. The impact of modern tomorrow, a better nation. This is our future. We can say that technology is changing and our future is changing. So your future is a better and the nation will be a better. In 2022, welcome to a new India, because now everything has been changed. It's true that the things were going in the previous year, but due to COVID, due to pandemic, lot of we have faced. But up to 2022, we are moving in the technology, and technology is changing the future, and you can run very well. So digital world is going to be come and India is also in the new millennium. So, few tips are here to become a successful entrepreneur. Have a passion for what you do. Consequently, set and achieve goals what you want to do. Be truthful and honest. Have emotional intelligence. Now see, that mean you are starting your business means that you have a trust in yourself. You have a confidence in yourself that what business you are starting, you can run your business. Keep confidence in you and later you will be a successful. There must be a patience. In the starting I have told you that patience is very important. If you have a patience, you are there to develop or grow your business. You continue, fail at last, the people did success. Addison is the example, 1000 words, time he was failure, and then later he become a successful and he has given the world, and today he is popular around the world. So you should have a trustful and honest, and emotional intelligence should be in you, and you can become a good entrepreneur. So, the business plan, it works. Does it work? Yes. No. If no, then go back. Again, does it work? If no, then go back. Does it work? Later, it will be yes and it will give you a dollar. So, this is your business plan. And to becoming a successful entrepreneur, you need a strategy, you need an innovation, you need an idea, you need an analysis, you have to grab the opportunity, what is the market, what is the planning, what is your team, these all things you have to decide, what are the customers, what they require, what they need, and through that, you can become a successful entrepreneur. So, at last, my message is that if you want to become an entrepreneur, you have to not to search a new idea from anywhere. Already existing business is available in the market. Go and search that market. See the business. You can choose from there. You have to add some new idea. You have to add the innovation. And later, add the technology because nowadays is the digitalization is emerging trend everywhere. In each and every sector, and you can do start your startup and you can become a entrepreneur. So my best wishes to all the students, those who have listened, and I think that those who have listened this to my lecture, they have learned, and if they require any time, any guidance from me, they can contact me, they can take my number from your sir, they have my number, so I will be available and I will be always ready to guide you and happy to be guide you. And if you will be an entrepreneur, then it is a very big part you are going to change our nation. Because I always say that our students are our future and you are going to change our nation. So be patient, do hard work. Think ideas, become an entrepreneur, become a job creator, don't become a job creator, don't stand in the queue, okay? Thank you very much sir, you have given me this opportunity to present my views in front of your students. I hope that students like my presentations and views. Thank you very much.
Thank you madam for the wonderful lecture on entrepreneurship. Now I request our dynamic director, Dr. Preeti Agarwal, madam, to address. Madam, please.
Thank you, sir. At the outset, Dr. Ashmi Gujarati, ma'am, thank you so much for this mesmerizing presentation. It was really, really, really good. You have covered almost all the parameters of startup and entrepreneurship, innovation, having the innovation incubation center on the campus and how high it is required. as national education policy also prescribes that we should create more number of entrepreneurs and job creators on the campus rather than the job seekers. And I must share with you, madam, I'm glad to share. Since I was in place innovation, education, entrepreneurship center, and we conduct many activities under the banner of this center every month or so to speak of the activity. We have a seed money also kept aside from Rasoni Trust for the season. And we have at least 5 to 6 success stories of startups on the campus because we are 2 institutions on this campus, a management institution offering MBA courses and engineering college offering 8 branches of engineering, including data science and AI. So we have signed many MOUs that we are equipped with family managed business of education institute. And in association with SPGM, we are actually offering the management certificate course to our students for certificate course in family managed business. And as you rightly said, the trade pattern for who can manage change, we only sometimes. So change is the buzzword, and it is not only the adaptive change, flexibility to the change. How fast we adapt to that change is also very important. And we are working in that line only. So you have like you said, back from years, you should have all the traits of entrepreneurs. And if you will go for a job in the industry, maybe start your own startup. All these traits have to be there in youngsters. So I am very sure that the Yambistan and Rasoni Institute must have been very, very enlightened with your nationalization. Thank you so much, madam. I'm looking forward for long-term relationships and many more such statements in future also. You have covered almost everything from the right from generating an idea till taking an idea into a commercialized product. And what are the steps involved in that process from idea to product? Everything has been covered by you. So thank you very much for finding time for budding entrepreneurs at Rasoni Institute. I appreciate the request of our Dean R&D, Dr. Saurabh Gupta, for initiating this event and all the participants. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, madam, for motivating. Just as a coordinator and as per the requirement of AICT, just I have to just give the summary of this. So this is Saurabh Gupta, coordinator of AICT Ministry of Education Center Lecture Series Coordinator. So first of all, I am thankful to two experts, Dr. Ankur Saxena, from Director, IIICT, Indus University, Ahmedabad, for giving the lecture on patent filing process and procedure. Then I am also thankful to second expert, Dr. Ashmi Gujarati Madam, it is Dean International Affairs, City University, Ludhiana. It will certainly help our students and faculty to innovate in new ways and to recognize their innovation in filing their patents and their publishing it. And second way is to make their career as an entrepreneurship, as the Madam has mentioned. So I am also thankful to AICT and Ministry of Education to provide the financial support for organizing this event. So in the last, I request Dr. Jyoti Jakhede Madam, Dean Triplai, to give up the vote of thanks. Jyoti Madam. Jyoti Madam, you are mute. Yes, ma'am.
A very good afternoon, one and all. I would like to thank Dr. Rashmi Shadi ma'am. Her session was so mesmerizing and we were really engrossed. I mean, we were attending the session along with the students of MBA and BBA. And so we have shared your started how what is the startup and the different insights that you have given in the journey of entrepreneur, that how an entrepreneur can be successful. That was really very, very mesmerizing session, ma'am. I would also like to thank coordinator Dr. Saurabh Gupta, sir, for taking all the initiatives and making such an impact lecture series a successful event for today. I would like to thank Director Giri Chattam sir and also our Executive Director Srikanthi Raisuri and Chairman sir Srikanthi Raisuri for supporting us in all our endeavors. Thank you ma'am. Thank you for this webinar. And also thank you to all the students and faculty for joining and attending this session.
Thank you madam. So there are some formalities are there. I noted two forms. One is feedback form for second session, that is Dr. Rashmi Gujarati madam. And second form is regarding the assessment team. It is just a formality to give the idea that how much you got. So that it is required to generate the certificate. As soon as you submit the sheet, you will automatically the certificate will be generated. Thank you madam. Thank you, Rashmi ma'am.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Yes.
Thank you,
Paligal, sir.
Thank you, sir.
So, all of you just take the link of the assessment sheet and make a form. Both are compulsory to generate the certificate. Okay, I will also circulate on WhatsApp group also, there is no problem, I will circulate it.
I'm going to go to the hospital.